For this experiment, I'm going to use the electrostatics kit and the charge sensor in the LabQuest 2 to do charging by induction. And it's a little bit complicated to be able to do this, but we'll walk you through the steps here. And so to start off with, I need to make sure that everything is uncharged at this point. So I've got myself attached to the ground plane here. I'm going to make sure that I zero this or ground that so that everything is uncharged. My charge separators here, I want to make sure first are not charged, and so I'm going to blot them on the wet cloth here. It's a cotton cloth that's wet so that they are don't have any excess charge. So I'm going to use the standard setup, 10 samples per second with a duration of 60 seconds for this experiment. At this point, I'll actually be able to begin data collection. So I'm going to hit collect and then rub the charge separators together. At first, I will insert the white nylon charge separator into the pail. And then I will take it out. Then I will insert it again, only this time I'm going to let it go there for a second, and I'll attach the ground wire to the inside of the pail for just a second, and then take the ground wire and put it back, and then remove the disc from the pail. If I put the disc back in again, we see this, and now I'll take it back out again, and the experiment's done. So let's hit stop here and take a look at our data. So at this part, this is when we've inserted the nylon disc into the pail. So we see that it goes up, and it's been similar to what you might see in other videos, but so it goes up there, and then it drops back down. And so now we stick it back in there. And at this point, we go and we touch the inside pail with the grounding wire, and so that it goes and now is at ground potential. And then we take the ground wire and we took it back and plugged it into where it was attached before. And now when we remove the charge separator, all of a sudden, we end up with the pail showing that it has a negative charge, a net negative charge. If we stick the charge separator back in again, then it seems to go back towards zero, and then if we move it, it goes back down. So what's happened here is that we've actually moved electrons from the ground plane to the inside pail by attaching it to the ground. And so they actually move there, and so when we move the charge separator, we actually see that the pail is now charged, but it's charged negatively, and we did it using a positively charged nylon charge separator. So we've seen some examples of how we might use the charge sensor. For more information about this, you can check out our website. So for information about the electrostatics kit, the high voltage kit to go with it, it's all there. So if you need more information, check that out.